Hi everyone, Dr. Nicole LaPera, the Holistic Psychologist here. So today's video is, in my opinion, incredibly important. It is how to get through an emotional trigger. What is a trigger? A trigger is when something in our present moment elicits a very big, as I put it really simply, a very big emotional reaction. A lot of us have these daily, sometimes multiple times a day, which is why I say this is one of the most important videos, in my opinion. So, the reason why the feeling is so big is because typically for most of us, what we're reacting to in the moment per se is much more than what's happening in the moment. Typically it's about something we're carrying with us from past experiences, from past pain, from past unmet needs that the current experience in a way is being filtered through. So the reaction I'm having when we understand where it's coming from is much more understandable. Right? If I am someone who's been, say, abandoned, and what's happening in the current moment is touching that deeper wound, then I might be able to understand why I'm kicking and screaming and yelling or detaching and dissociating, having that size of an emotional reaction, because it's about, for me in this moment, all of the times I've been abandoned or all of those pains that I've carried along the way. And I share this with you because I think sometimes in our own internal critical voice, we can be really mean to ourselves. What the hell is wrong with you? Why are you reacting to this extent about this little thing that happened? Also, in our partnerships or people watching our reaction might be a bit confused or critical, but I like to explain where it's coming from because this is real. The emotions that are happening when we're emotionally triggered or emotionally activated are a mind-body experience that is actually real and valid. So how do we get through? Three steps, incredibly important. The first step, those of you who follow me know I'm a big fan of this step, which is breathing. Why is breathing important? When we are activated, our body is activated. So for some of us, what that means is we're having actually a nervous system response. That fight or flight, that concept that a lot of us now are very familiar with, the trigger might be sending us into that fight or flight mode, meaning our nervous system is reacting. So breathing, the easiest breath work that I'm always going on and on about, is that deep belly breath. So hand on belly, 1, 2, 3, nice deep breaths into my belly, nice slow exhales. That first step will actually help calm that physiological nervous system response that's happening when we're emotionally activated with a trigger. Again, as all things, this takes practice. So practice belly breathing all the time. Don't wait to practice for the moment when you're triggered to remember that belly breath. Two things are gonna happen. You're not gonna remember this concept of belly breathing, or if you do, you're not gonna be practiced in it enough. Because for some of us, it feels weird at first. When I first started belly breathing, I was so used to being a very shallow chest breather that I had to retrain my body so that when I needed that breath to calm me down, when I was actually emotionally triggered, I was much more successful at using it. So practice all the time. And when we're feeling ourselves be triggered, definitely do those deep belly breaths. It'll calm that emotional reaction. Step two, practice witnessing the ego as an observer. So what do I mean by this? In the moment, so say for instance, I'm going to use this abandonment example. Say for instance, you know, I'm not getting a response back from my partner. Longer time has passed between texts than I would like. So my mind starts spinning a story of, oh, it's because she's abandoning me in this moment. And that's what's causing that reaction. If I can teach myself to witness that story that my ego has told me, that old story of abandonment, really a million things my partner could be doing in that moment. Maybe she's busy, maybe she's in a meeting, maybe she's taking a bath, maybe she's sleeping. Not abandoning me at all. So if I can teach myself in that moment to see that story of abandonment as separate, to observe that story, that's what my ego is telling me. Oh, she's abandoning you in that moment. That's why I'm feeling hurt, devastated, angry, whatever I might be feeling. So the more we practice what we're hearing, that narrative, that story, what our ego is telling us, and separating, observing it, then over time, we get to show up in that moment and give ourselves a new choice, right? I may in that moment select a different narrative for what's happening as opposed to the one my ego is going to naturally offer, which is I'm being abandoned. I can now practice saying, okay, ego, thank you. I appreciate your attempt at protecting me in this moment, but in reality, my partner's not abandoning me. in reality, a million other things are probably happening in her world, and now I may choose to respond in a new way. Again, caveat here is all things, practice. This doesn't happen overnight. The more we observe our ego, the stories, what the narrative is that I'm assigning, or the meaning that I'm assigning to this event, that's my trigger, that's what's happening, the more I can practice separating myself up and making room for a new response. 3, practice self-acceptance. Now this is back to what I was saying at the beginning. Honoring the fact that your feelings are very valid in that moment, right? You're emotionally activated. There's hormones that are being released in your body and neurotransmitters and energy shifts and changes, and that's real. Not only is it real in this moment, it comes from a very real place of pain. For a lot of you, pain that's probably been stored and carried across your life thus far. So honoring that realness and those emotions as they're coming up is a big practice of self-acceptance, letting it all be okay. Because I know a lot of us have a voice that watches these emotions that are coming up and feels them and says, you know what, I shouldn't feel this way, or this isn't okay to feel this way. Right? So the more we can honor that in our bodies we are really having an emotional reaction that can need tending to soothe, go take that walk, go take that bath yourself, give your energy time to come back down to baseline, because that's a real experience in your body. So by breathing, by learning how to witness our ego or the stories that are wrapped up in these emotional triggers, and by making the feelings okay for ourselves so that we can release them and allow them to actually leave over time so that we don't have to be so acutely triggered as we evolve into the future, is an incredibly empowering process too. Because a lot of the time when we're triggered, we feel like we're living reactively to life, because we are. Our past is dictating what we're gonna do in this moment now. So the more we practice these 3 steps, we're stepping into empowerment. We're stepping into a responsive way of navigating our current moment and some of the big feelings that might be from past experiences still happening in the moment, but we can leave feeling like a much more empowered space that we've created for ourselves, where we get to choose, not our ego, we get to choose how we respond. We get to learn that we can calm our body, we can calm our nervous system, and we can honor all of the feelings that we've accumulated along our journey so far. So I hope you found this video helpful. Any of you who have not yet subscribed, if you like what you heard, that would be awesome if you hit the subscribe button.